friends. What would it be like if you had to leave your family and go to a brand new place? Would you miss your family? Well, last week we learned that Jacob had to leave his family to escape from his angry brother Esau, who wanted to kill him. Now, Jacob was on his way to Haran to find his uncle Laban. On his way, God made a promise to Jacob at a place called Bethel. God promised that he would be with Jacob and bring him back to the land where he grew up. This changed Jacob's heart. But before he became the godly leader of his family, there were a few more changes God had in store for him. Say it with me, God can make me new. Jacob traveled many days and finally arrived in Haran. He stopped at a well where some shepherds were waiting to water their sheep. He asked the shepherds if they knew of his uncle Laban. They told him, yes, his daughter is actually coming to water her family's sheep. Jacob turned and saw a young woman named Rachel coming toward him. Jacob had found his uncle's family. Not waiting for the other men to help, Jacob lifted the heavy stone and rolled it off the well so he could get water for Rachel's sheep. Jacob introduced himself to Rachel as a son of her aunt Rebecca. Rachel was excited to meet him and hurried home to tell her father, Laban. Laban came quickly to meet Jacob, hugging him and inviting him to his house. It must have been exciting for Laban to hear all about his sister Rebecca and her family. Jacob became part of Laban's family, along with Laban's sons and his two daughters, Leah and Rachel. He lived in Laban's home for a month and helped with the sheep. And one day, Laban came to him with an offer. Since we are like family, you shouldn't have to work for me for nothing. Tell me what your wages should be. Laban was expecting to pay Jacob, but Jacob wanted something else instead. You see, he had fallen in love with Rachel, and so he said, I'll work for you for 7 years in return for your younger daughter, Rachel. 7 years seems like a long time, but Jacob was willing to stay at Laban's home and work for him so that he could marry Rachel. The 7 years went by quickly for Jacob. He loved Rachel and was glad to work hard so he could have her as his wife. Finally, the day of the wedding came. Laban invited his friends to a great wedding feast. In the evening, he brought his daughter to Jacob. She wore the usual bridal clothes of her country with a heavy veil covering her head and face, and she became Jacob's wife. In the morning, Jacob discovered he had actually married Leah, the older sister, instead of Rachel. Oh no! Laban had tricked Jacob! Jacob must have been very confused, hurt, and angry. He had been deceived. Why do you think God allowed this to happen? Perhaps God wanted Jacob to see how wrong it is to deceive others. God wanted to change Jacob to be more like him. But what about Rachel? What about Jacob's love for her? Laban promised Jacob that he could marry Rachel too, and if he worked another 7 years for him. Jacob agreed. He married Rachel and continued to work for Laban. Now, Jacob had two wives. This was not unusual in the time and place where Jacob lived, but having more than one wife was not how God set up marriage. But Jacob married Rachel anyway. Deceit is a terrible thing. Jacob and his family would suffer consequences because of Laban's sin of deceit. As years went by, Jacob's family grew. By the time he had been with Laban 20 years, Jacob had many children. Jacob had also become a rich man. Through an agreement with Laban, he was paid with some of Laban's sheep, and over the years, Jacob's flock grew very large. One day, God spoke to Jacob. The Lord said to Jacob, "Go back to the land of your fathers and to your relatives, and I will be with you." It was time for Jacob to return to the land of Canaan. But what about Esau? If Jacob goes back home, surely he will have to face Esau, who was angry with him and wanted to kill him. Well, stay tuned next week to find out what happens next. But, you know, the reassuring thing is that God told Jacob, "I will be with you." That is the most comforting thing to hear when you are feeling scared, fearful, or even lonely. God is always with you, and He wants to make you more like Jesus. Next week, we'll find out how God changes Jacob to make him new.